Okay, here we are. Yet another Linux out of the box. And tonight we're doing openSUSE Tumbleweed. Same computer as usual. No changes there. 9060 XT, Ryzen 9. Now, I have to be honest, openSUSE, that's the way to pronounce it, it's not been on my radar at all. It's one of those, you know, Bazai, catchy, all these things, Ubuntu. But it's just not been there. And I was like going through the list of distributions I'd not looked at yet. And I thought, well, you know, it's a bit, to me, it's a bit fringe. I'll get shot down for that. But I thought, okay, but here we go. Now, there's two ways you can install it. I've tried both on here, but I've gone for the standard. There's a net version which pulls everything down, but I'm going for the standard ISO. So it'll just pull it in, boots up, get that installation. Yeah, so this is sort of like one of the fringe ones that, but apparently it's really good, and it's very modern, and up to date, and it's a, you know, very good. There's a, I mean, I don't know the, very much about the history behind it, and I'm not going to go bore you to death with the history of Linux, but I mean, you know, from what I've seen, it's quite slick. It's actually quite good, but I have read some stuff saying from people online saying, oh, it's not for beginners, you know, and on this quest to move people from Windows. Off of Windows and OS X onto Linux, there shouldn't really be any Linux package open to the public, which should be too hard for beginners. It should all have, I mean, it's all fundamentally the same thing, isn't it, right? It's an operating system. So, you know, it should be made so people can use it, and you don't have to be experts to use it. And this, you know, as I go through this, this isn't too bad. I mean, it's supposed to be for experts. Not really. I mean, I'm not an expert by a long margin. But it does what it says in the tin. There's one really stupid thing I've discovered we'll come to, which is just the dumbest thing. And if this single piece of information was shared with people when they install Linux, particularly certain versions of, I think Fedora's foul of it as well. Here we go. UK English, usual thing, license agreements. Yeah, if this single piece of information was shared with people on certain distributions of Linux, their lives would be infinitesimally better. Online repositories, just click yes. Yes, next, maybe, don't know what it means. Report stuff, software stuff in the cloud. Does it help me? Hopefully. I mean, you know, it's standard installer, and it's quite nice. The install on this is really sweet. Look on the left hand side, it's sort of just telling you what it's doing step by step. Now you can pick your desktop. Plasma's the one I always choose, it's GNOME. KFC is really lightweight, generic, and hardcore, which is the server one where they probably know no GUI and you just have to remember stuff. Disk partitioning, no issues. It just did it. Very sweet. So don't know what that's about. Click next. It just worked out where I am. Yep. And then in we go. Username. Easiest thing to type. Password will be similar. Yeah. I always believe if you don't have a password, it's people try and guess it and it'll always be wrong, won't it? And people will never get it. They just never leave it blank. Not that I do that. Anyway, yes, I really want to use it. It's good, though. It's good security, isn't it? Telling you that you've done a dumb password. What are the most popular passwords? Is it sunshine, God, and something else? Anyway, so off we go. Confirm installation. Now, even though I'm doing this off the ISO, I've sped this up enormously because, I mean, I don't think you want to sit through the whole thing. Now, here we go. All miraculously, I've got 1 terabyte internet. No, well, very fast USB key. So that's going to whiz in there, and then we'll get to the end of that. And there we go. Boom. Reboot. And then we'll boot back up again. So pretty painless installation process. Mere mortals can do it. I accidentally installed the other version of openSUSE, which did come with a GUI. And that was a bit of a worry. It's like looking at just text. So back in, that's nice. Nice colours. It's a nice look to it. And the kernel version, that is 16.6, which is very new. Yeah, I think this is what's called a rolling release. So it's like modern and up to date. So what have we got going on here? loading. That's nice. That's cool. And we're into the desktop standard. Ahoy, this is openSUSE. Stuff, get software, whatever. Now, let's have a quick look around here. What we got? Utilities, system, office is in there already. And then you've got Discover, which is the plasma shop, which is great. You know, oh, update issue. Those are doing it. Try again. Oops. Not such a good start. We'll just move on from that. So, as usual, we're going to put OBS on here. We're going to put Steam and run a game. And we're also going to do some new this time on one of them. And this, I should have did this ages ago. I'm going to install an AI onto here. The AI front end, because I suppose the, when you're in Linux, you can have a million questions, aren't you? So if you have an AI handy on your desktop without having to go to the internet, it might be quite useful. So there's a really good software, and we'll go through that bit in a minute, of installing it. So, yeah, so I'm going to basically install everything, I think, and then I'm going to come back instead of making you sit through and watch me install it. So let's just get Steam on the go. Use the Flatpak version, that one. And what else was I going to put on it? Oh, let's do the word processor whilst we're here before we jump back into anything else. I think that's the best way. Just have a quick one. Proton Plus. All sorts of good things. Yeah, so let's just try out the word processor. Office. Writer. Benchmark moment here. How many words per minute can it get out? Possible. The Matrix has you. It does indeed. It does indeed, Neo. So, okay, so that works. Save it, yes. Put that there. Great. That works. Yeah, so we're going to jump ahead now. Boom. And now this is the, what we're going to do is you've got OBS is on there. Steam's on there. And I've installed a thing called Alpaca. And when you install it, you have to install some extra bits with it. You'll see there's a thing called a Llama package manager or something. And it's an AI, and it's great. It basically delete chat. Hang on, I was just fiddling around with that. And when you install it, this comes up, and you get a little thing, and you click on that. You've got all the available AIs you can use. Then you download some. I've got what have I got there? Llama 3.1. And then you've got it on your desktop. You can choose which one at the top there. 8 billion parameters, 16 gig. Because I've, this is, oh, it's a bit screwed up this. Basically, I've got a 9060 XT card and that, and the implementation, the Rockham thing, which ATI has for AI doesn't work here on this. I need a newer version. So this will all get loaded into RAM. So it'll be a bit slower than usual. So there's no like GPU acceleration with this. So there you go. Help me with openSUSE. And you know, if you're NVIDIA, by the way, if you're a NVIDIA user, this would work like rocket ships. You've got CUDA installed properly, which well, I would imagine it will install CUDA. So, yeah, you would just, this would just go for gold. But there you go. You've got an AI on your desktop, and you can basically ask it questions. 8 billion parameter model, probably great for most things. What else have we got going on here? Done office, multimedia. Let's have a look at OBS. And I'll tell you about the stupid thing right at the end whilst I'm talking over the game bit. Use your part. OBS installed perfectly. No problem whatsoever. Does its basic test thing. Tells me what I can do. And then I'll have a look at what sort of encodings set up that I can actually use on this. Let's have a look in settings. And there we go, we've got AV1, H.265, and H.264. Display capture. Display, that works fine. So, yeah, so you're all right for a bit of streaming. You're all right for a bit of word processing. And are you okay for a bit of gaming? Now, okay, so I've already downloaded a game. I'm going to do a different one. I've done Dredge on every single one of these I've done, but I'm going to do Dishonored, which is a great game. and I've done this because I've realized what's been going on. I think with Fedora and any of the Red Hat based ones, basically there's a thing, and all the Linux people can laugh at me now, called SE Linux, which basically means this security enhanced Linux. It's all to do with the NSA putting patches on stuff and making Linux more secure. However, for the average gamer on the planet, or person who wants to use Linux for desktop, you know, for normal purposes, it's a pain in the backside. It's a security layer. Anyway, if somebody has said at some point in this, if you're going to play games, there's one line of code you have to type and then everything works perfectly, that would be a big jump forward. And it is one of these things with Linux I've discovered. I'll put the line of code in the description. It just installs a tiny package that allows you to play games properly. It's ridiculous. If this was like somewhere at the beginning of this, this is, what are you going to do? You're going to use it as a desktop. You're going to play games on Linux. What are you going to do? If you're going to play games, you need to do this. That would say probably so many. I was Googling and I realized that there's a lot of people out there like me going, why doesn't my Steam launch? Anyway, this is Dishonored. This is Dishonored 2. It's a brilliant game. French company, I think. It's really, really cool. I can't even describe the story. It's a fictional town, but it runs, I'm only at 1080p because I'm recording this, but it runs amazingly well on here, like most games do. Proton, Steam, it's a match made in heaven. It means I can play. I'm just going through, I'm doing some, if you've had a look, I'm doing a lot of YouTube shorts. I'm just literally playing every game I have for 3 minutes on Bazaar, just to show which games work. I've had a few surprising ones that haven't worked, which has been odd, but I'm just going through them. So I've done some really random indie games I bought on completely on a whim, and put those in some games I've actually got and never played for some bizarre reason. Some stuff my son's bought. I don't know why we've got it on the system. Having a shared Steam account in the house is a bit of an epic. But yeah, anyway, so openSUSE, Tumbleweed. It's really good. It's really good, actually. I'm really impressed with it. It's right up there, like catchy, Bazaar. This, really, this is really, so this is, and like Manjaro was great as well. That worked off the bat. So there's some really good distributions out there. I mean, this is really slick. I love the little light bulb thing at the beginning. There's a lot of detail in this one. So if you're going to give it a go, I'll put the line of code. I mean, this probably worked for Fedora, CentOS, Rocky, all the other ones that have got SE Linux on. It's just a simple line of code and let you play games. And you can, you know, have a much happier life than spending time Googling on forums with people who will say things like, don't be so angry why your games don't work. It is frustrating. It is frustrating. Just a little bit of note at the beginning would have helped everybody there. Anyway, that's it. openSUSE. Thanks for watching.